the next speaker, Elena Shishkina. The title is Solution of the Cache Problem for Generalized
Hyperbolic Equation. And this equation is closely connected to weighted spherical mean and to the risk potential. More precisely, with the hyperbolic B potential of risk. And in particular case, this equation is singular Cantor equation, and it could be interesting for relativists. So we pay attention here to this first equation, and we will solve problem 1, 2 to this equation. Here, gamma I is greater than 0, and k is any real number. This equation we will call generalized EPD equation, and in convenient space we will obtain the solution of such problem.
About k, what? Positive would also
is a real number.
A real number.
Real. For positive number, the solution of such problem will be unique, and for negative, it will not unique, but still we can we will see how the solution of this problem will depend on some functions, and we will obtain one solution and additional expression which can be added to this solution. Let's start from short history. This equation was studied in Euler's work, in later in Poisson, Darbo, and Riemann works presented here. Next, so-called Maryland Mathematical School, which was Alexander Bernstein was the idea leader of this school, and he has very good results and very good methods to obtaining the solution to a Euler-Poisson-Darbo equation when gamma I is equal to 0 for all I from 1 to n, and for C equals to 0. And after that, student of Bernstein, David Fox, obtained the solution of the problem 1, 2 when C is equal to 0, but he had exceptional cases when K were equal to minus 1, minus 3, minus 5, etc. Solution which we will see here will cover this case when C is equal to 0, but in the solution will be written in a spherical mean, weighted spherical mean. But by David Fox, this solution was obtained in terms of Lauricella function, it is a generalized function of special function. And here we present papers. These papers, it is possible to find these results which I mentioned. Next, the idea to use Fourier transform to solve this problem when, of course, gamma I R equals equal to zero and C is equal to zero too. Such studies was done by Bresters, and as for abstract polar Poisson-Darboux equation, results were obtained by Bouchard. Next, we present here the part of Euclidean space, and we will use usual notation for coordinates, and we will use this area, this set. And next, we introduce so-called even with respect to each variable functions, and following to Professor Kipiyanov, it means that all derivatives of order 2k plus 1 are equal to 0 in origin. And if we have functions infinitely differentiable and with such conditions, we will use this sign to following to Kipriyanov, and such kind of condition also was appeared in Zhytomyrsky papers. And of course, in problems connected to this operator, this condition should be. Next, we will use this space of function, space of finite function, and we will use this space as one space of test functions. Next space, which we will use as a space of test function, is a part of Schwarz space of even with respect of each variable function. And next, we present here multi-index gamma and a space LP gamma weighted Lebesgue space with such kind of norm. Here we can see we will use power weight. To introduce LP infinity space, we will use such kind of weighted measure and such kind of weighted distribution function defined by this equality. And here we can see a norm of L infinity gamma space, and also using as a test functions D plus and S if we can consider weighted functionals defined by three functionals, linear continuous functionals defined by three will be called regular, and also we can use singular weighted functionals, linear plus continuous. This operator we will call Bessel operator. In Voronezh, the first who studied such kind of operator was Professor Kipriyanov. After him, a lot of good scientists, my advisor, Professor Vlyakov and Professor Sitnik, and a lot of scientists in Voronezh studied problems with the Bessel operator. And using notation which was presented by Kipriyanov, this notation, we will call this operator Laplace-Bessel operator. We can move further. Here we can see so-called normalized Bessel function, and big G is a usual, regular basic function of the first kind. And for basic operator and for small g, we have equality sets. Next, we will need some more basic functions, the first and second kind of Hankel functions, and functions y. Next, we need modified basic functions and of the first and the second kind too. Here we present Hankel transform or Fourier basic transform, and here we have the kernel of this transform, and next we can see inverse Hankel transform. Here, generalized convolution operator is presented, and this operator is generalized translation operator defined by this equality, and each one-dimensional generalized translation operator is defined by this formula. First, this operator was appeared in the sub. Papers, and next by Professor Levitan, this operator was studied very well, and another generalized translation operators as well. Using this generalized translation, we will construct so-called weighted spherical mean operator. Here, S1 plus is the part of unit sphere. And for this operator, we have property 12. And next, we have some lemmas about Hankel transform and Laplace Bessel operator. And this lemma, which show how we can calculate integral of kernel of Hankel transform over the part of unit sphere. Next, we will use regular weighted functional 15, and we will use a lot of regular weighted functionals connected with quadratic form. Here, we following two Gilfand-Shilov ideas to use a quadratic form connected to differential operator. And as we have here hyperbolic differential operator, we will use not defined quadratic form. Here we present also another weighted generalized function 16, 17, and 18, and also functions 19 and 20. All of these functions are connected with quadratic form of this form. Here AK is a real, or with such kind of form we have P positive and Q negative summed here, and we will use all these functions. Next, we can present some formulas connected with such generalized functions. First formula is presented here. We can see how operator close to Laplace Bessel operator acts to this function. If we put here AK equals to 1, we get Laplace Bessel operator, and if we will have Q positive and Q negative summons, we will get our hyperbolic operator, which is in the left side of our APD equation. Next, we have some formulas which are present Hankel transform of our weighted functionals connected with quadratic form. This formula 21, they all give us different basic functions. Here we have two summoned, and this one is a basic function, and Q is a quadratic form, is a weighted generalized function connected with quadratic form, and depending on Q. Q is a variable which we get when we apply Hankel transform. So, using this result, we can obtain solution. Also, we will use formulas 24 and 25. We can see also here basic functions. And 26 and 27 gives us another basic functions. So, we are interested in the solution of this kind of Cauchy problem, and using all results which was presented in appropriate space, that means we have space as if space of distributions on S E by variables X and by variable T functions belongs to C2, and we get the solution of our problem, which is given by this equality. This is generalized convolution operator. This is our function connected with the quadratic form, normalized basic function, and function from the first initial condition. And for k greater or equal to zero, this solution is unique. Next, if k less than zero but not equal to negative odd numbers, we obtain that the difference between two arbitrary solutions is always has the form 31. And here u with 2 minus k is a solution of this Cauchy problem. And here psi is a arbitrary function of this space. Next, we are interested in exceptional cases of k. And here we also have that solution of the Cauchy problem is not unique, and this solution will contain term thirty-one, and also it will contain this term. Next, we have some corollaries. First, we have the solution of the singular Klein-Gordon equation, and here we do not have this operator by variable t. Next, we know that the Klein-Gordon equation is interested for is interesting equation in quantum mechanics. Next is when c is equal to zero, we obtain that the solution of this Cauchy problem has this form, and the solution of such kind Cauchy problem was obtained by David Fox first using Lavoisier functions, and after that this result was obtained in a paper written by Professor Ляп, Professor Половинкин and me, using weighted spherical mean operator. And using weighted spherical mean operator, the solution was more convenient than if we will use a Lavoisier function. And also in we obtain the solution in an exceptional case when k is equal to minus 1, minus 3, and minus 5, etc. Next, we have when k is greater to this number, we can use regular, we can obtain a regular solution because the convolution product which we had earlier will just regular integral, and we can calculate it. And so we can obtain this solution, and after that we can use Adamard decent method and obtain regular solution for k less than this number.
And here, emit gamma spherical mean, emit gamma function.
Yes, yes. Here, this is weighted spherical mean, which is constructed using by generalized translation. It was presented earlier. Next, we have. Next, we have some examples. Here we have example for this condition, and it was calculated that weighted spherical mean acts to this kernel of Hunting transform in this way, and we can calculate this solution, and it will have this form for such kind of initial conditions. And next we will give some plots of these solutions. One for c equals to zero, next for c equals to one, two, four, etc. And next, briefly, I present the solution of non-homogeneous general Euler-Poisson equation. Here we have iterated operator, and we have such kind of conditions. And in this case, the solution of this problem is hyperbolic Ries bipotential. The order of this potential should be equal to 2L. And this k plus is a part of Korn, and r is
Lorentz distance.
Lorentz distance, yes. And only one problem we have here. This integral converges absolutely only for these values of alpha. And if we have here m which is not in these values. We should use analytic continuation. It is not very difficult to construct it. We just should use integration by part. But it depends on this value of alpha or L, how many times we should integrate by part this not very easy, not very simple integral. But still, it is possible to obtain the solution of this problem. Thank you for your attention.
That's it. Okay. Please, questions?
Are there some concrete physical problems which can be solved by applying your method?
First of all, when we have Bessel operator, it was mentioned many times that we have radial symmetry in some variables. Next, we have trichomy equation, and also we have a lot of application to Radon transform, for example, in Helgason book. It is possible to find it, and this equation and this potential will be connected to generalized Radon transform. Also, have this subject has application to concurrent flow operators and to construct this generalization of such kind of operators. But as for physics, it is probably a Radon operator equation.
Your question, please.
I'm interested in the following. You mentioned about shift operators. If you consider shift operator, then we can consider semigroups of shift operators, and the generator of semigroups is well defined. I was inspired in the following. We can consider fractional powers of a generator, and there is a deep theory of fractional powers of semigroups generator. But if you study fractional Bessel operators on and very interesting the next question on what sets Bessel fractional operator and fractional power of generator of semigroups shift operators will coincide on what sets. It's very interesting for me, and this question inspired me not only in context Bessel operator, all operators of fractional differential. Thank you very much.
But that looks like this. I'm sorry. We have no time for discussion.
Yes.
Discussion is for the day.
Yes.
Late. So, and we have no time for other questions, please. I'm sorry. Other questions after finish of the section. Thank you very much for your talk. The next.